If I were you, I'd keep away from the barrow on the east side of town. It's haunted. The Greybeards are a solitary lot. I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit, but almost all of them have returned disappointed.
I told you to cut those boards at twice arm length. My arm's length, not yours.
I'm so sorry.
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away.
Everyone isn't as short as you are.
I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul. Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow? If you think there's anything you can do, be my guest. About a year or two ago, some fella named Windelius came through. Said he was some kind of a treasure hunter. I warned him not to go in there, just like I warned you. The very next night, we heard screams from the barrow, and that was it. We never saw him again. If you're headed up to the monastery, watch your step. It's a long way down.
If you ever s*** to have children, think twice before you do it.
To wonder, what does the Dragon Ball do, summoned by the Greybeards? Can the Thune be taught, like any skill?
No lollygagging.
This has to be the worst place in Skyrim to run a mill. How am I supposed to do anything with all those bears running around? The Greybeards stay away from me, and I stay away from them. Suits me just fine. My business is falling apart, my apprentice never listens to me, and now there's talk of dragons. If I hadn't sunk every bit of gold I had into my mill, I would have picked up and left Iverstead long ago. Are you kidding? Those damn things will drive me right out of business. Tell you what. Bring me 10 of their pelts from anywhere in Skyrim. I'll gladly pay you for thinning out the herd. Have you ever seen what a bear does to the trees? They jump on their hind legs and scratch them to bits, marking their territory or something. It's getting to the point where I have to scour Skyrim for untouched trees at the right size. Cost me too much time and money. Now go give those stupid bears what's coming to them.
The gods gave you two hands, and you used them both for your weapon.
Challenge! Tell you what, you start running so I can stab you in the back.
Care for work? Get an axe and bring me all the wood you can chop. Nice to finally meet someone who can follow simple instructions. Here's your reward, as promised. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to work. If you get a chance, kill a few more bears for me, will you?
Thank you.
don't get many visitors through here. Unless they're headed up to High Hrothgar, of course.
Let me see that. I can't believe this. It was all just a fabrication of this Windelius character. I can't believe we were so stupid.
Well, least I can do is give you something for taking care of him. If you won't accept it as a payment, consider it a gift. If you're headed up to the monastery, watch your step. It's a long way down. Keep an eye out for wolves if you're headed up the path to High Hrothgar. Enjoying the hospitalities of the inn. Suggest you do the same. All right, then.
Oh. Thank you. What?
Nah!